Hi students, in this video we are going to see basic system properties and properties related to memory. We will see in this video. So we'll see a systems with and without memory. Let's define a system which is a memoryless. A system is said to be memoryless if its output for each value of the independent variable at a given time is dependent only on the input at that same time. So the keywords are this: a system is said to be a memoryless when the output depend only on the input at that same time. Example, y of n is 2x of n minus x square n whole square. Though it is looking like a very complicated equation, but still, see here, I want y of n, and y of n is obtained only by knowing x of n. Means, suppose I want y of 0. So I just need to know what is x of 0. I want to have y of 2. I just need to know what is there at n equal to 2 in the input signal. So output at any instant depend upon whatever the input is present at that particular instant only. That is what a memoryless system. Memoryless system is also called as static system. So sometimes we repeat, sometimes we may use the word static system. It's nothing but a memoryless system. Memory is not required because output depends only on the input at that particular instant. Let's write an equation for system with memory. So example of a system with memory. A simple example is delaying any sequence. For example, a delay of input signal means system represented by this y of n is nothing but x of n minus 1. See the problem now. Suppose I want to know what is y of 0. As per the system equation, y of 0 is nothing but x of minus 1. What conclusion we can draw? to get a y of 0, I should know what is the input at n equal to minus 1. So output depends on previous value of input. So in order to know the previous value of input, memory is required. So obviously this system is a system with a memory, also called as a dynamic system. So let's take an example in a continuous time domain. Once again, I will take an example of a register. So register is there, and for the register, I'm having a current I of t, so that it will give a voltage V of t. I can say V of t is a system with equation R into I of t. So at any instant of time t, if I want to know the voltage across a resistor, I just need to know what is the current flowing through a resistor at that particular instant. But suppose I'm having inductor, and the current flowing through it, let's take, is I of t, and L is the value. Here also voltage will be developed, which is VLt. So in this case, suppose I need to know what is the voltage across inductor. It is VLt equal to, it's a differential term, L di by dt. But doing so, one more thing I need to know, and that thing is that in this I of t, I should know what is the initial value of inductor current, meaning the exact equation will be L into I0. The thing is that in order to know the voltage of an inductor, I need to know what is the current flowing before switching this inductor. That means an initial value of the current flowing through the inductor is known. It should be known. So right over here, initial value of current through inductor must be known. So I can say initial value should be known. That means I need to have a memory. Hence this system will be a dynamic, but this system will be static. So this is static and this is dynamic. So in this video we have seen, based on the memory required or not, system can be classified as static and dynamic. Static means memory less, do not require memory, output depends only on the present value of input, whereas dynamic is a system with a memory, can be depends upon a previous or future values of the input. Hence it's called as a system which is a dynamic, required memory. Thank you.